So the company was founded in 2016 by Luc van Dijk with the aim to really bring machine learning into aviation. We are likely going to certify the first machine learning enabled avionics in a safety critical use case in aviation this year. And so yeah, that's very exciting. We have at the moment 150 employees. We are based in Zurich in Switzerland. Probably 120 employees are based in Zurich. 30 employees are based in Riga, Latvia, where we do data annotation. And we have in Phoenix our office for the US with another 5 employees, mostly sales representatives, product management, field service, and so forth. In terms of funding, we have raised over 80 million Swiss francs. The visual traffic detection system detects uncooperative and cooperative traffic. And we see, let's say, paragliders, drones, etc. We are certifying this use case with EASA and the FAA. For example, I think what will help in the future is, of course, the landing guidance, right? Now, we have a lot of airports that have ILS, but there's also airports that don't have any facilities. And since we have an onboard aircraft system, we can operate at those airports and we can do landing guidance. We can show the pilots, where are you, let's say, compared to the runway, and guide you towards the runway. So it's even if there's no ILS, there is no issue. We have the topic of, let's say, runway incursions. We increasingly see the number of runway incursions. We can actually see if there's an aircraft on the landing site on the runway, if there's a car crossing. So that's going to help there as well. So that will increase capacity at those airports, as an example. Very advanced use case is good as a navigation. So we basically visual navigation. If you are flying in let's say GPS denied environment, we can use our system to navigate. We have done a fantastic flight with Moog. We recently integrated our system into the Moog FMS and their autopilot on a Bell 0858 test platform, where we navigated over a distance of 70 nautical miles based on our camera system. And we flew closed loop with the autopilot, with the navigation system active, with the VTD active, with the landing guidance active when we got to the landing point. So this was, for us, the very first time that we actually did a closed loop flight. We are serving both the manned market, right, which is a pilot aid at the moment. So we are there DALC, so we're certifying to DALC. So it's a pilot assisted their system. And at the same time, the autonomous unmanned market we are going into here. So if we come to, so let's say autonomy, we see a lot of, let's say, remotely piloted platforms today already, right? And we see that, okay, if you operate these type of platforms, and once you lose your data connection or something is, the aircraft has to fly by itself. And so we add to that stack, autonomy stack, the vision-based technologies that we need to fly autonomously. Hence, let's say, traffic detection, navigation, wire detection, all of these things that you would not be able to do today otherwise. There is no data link, so we get the sensor arms, our normal cameras, electrical-optical cameras, certifiable that we developed. We are stepping into infrared at the moment as well, by the way. This data has been fed into the box that we have, the compute box that we also developed ourselves to be certifiable. And it's all on the platform itself. So there's no data link needed to the ground to actually do the calculations and show what is going on. And it's all on the aircraft. So the biggest hurdle that we took is, of course, certification. So there was no way to certify machine learning for safety critical use cases. So we have developed this with EASA and the FAAs and come to a process of how to do this. Of course, the bar is really high, so that's a big step to take. We are working hard on it. We are making very good progress. This year, we hope to certify the very first use case. It needs a lot of data as well, as we know, right? Machine learning needs a lot of data to be fed in. So we have our 2 aircraft, our helicopter. We're collecting data in all of the ecoregions in the US, in, let's say, Europe. And that data we need to train the model. And at the same time, we need another extra data set to verify the algorithm. So it does the same thing for any given input. It gives the same output. We are very well cooperating with EASA and the FAA, both of them. They are very interested and eager to be able to certify this. Machine learning is a known technology. Computer vision is a known technology. Yet, how do you certify this? And how can you make aviation safety benefit from this and make aviation more more economical, increase capacity, increase the safety of things. So yes, EASA and the FAA are very interested in this, but it needs to be done right. So the bar is really high. We're taking the right steps to gain experience and certify. So far, we have a lot of good conversations, mostly in the innovation side of the big OEMs. They're very interested. We're doing demonstrations. We have been working with Leonardo a lot to do demonstrations on their helicopters. We are working with Moog very well, right? And we see a lot of demand from the manned side of aviation. This is both civil and also military. And now we're stepping into the autonomous, more unmanned side of aviation, even the military. So we see demand coming up for counter-drone activities, where we also use the same technology and benefit from the certification because we have assured AI and can actually assure that it's giving always giving the same output for a given input and make sure it reaches its target. We are benefiting basically from the material that we have developed for the civil side of things. To detect an aircraft is to detect an aircraft. And yet the USP of the Daedalean is to be able to certify this. So to really assure it is doing the right thing. We see a lot of companies, of course, getting into machine learning in the military sector. That is all great, but we have to be sure it works. And I think with our USP being able to certify things, even in the civil world, we can assure the AI is doing its job as it is supposed to do. So that is also going well. And this is, of course, the market entry, the lowest barrier to get into. At the same time, we continue with the certification and make sure that that rapidly we follow up with the helicopter operations, with the larger unmanned platforms that need certification in both, let's say, military and also civil. So in a pure sense, I would say military first, because it's a rapidly, let's say, innovating segment at the moment, and a civil will then soon follow and also have the benefits from this. The next milestones is that we, let's say, certify the first, let's say, the AI-enabled avionics. It's going to be this year. That's a very big, important milestone because that will unlock all of the conversations we're having with these manned helicopter operations. That's a very important milestone. I would highlight the event for the certification, to look out for a certification, because there we are really writing history, and that we will have the first AI-enabled avionics software in a safety-critical use case in aviation. That is writing history. To our knowledge, has not been done so far on a dull sea level. So Paris Air Show has been great for us. We've had a lot of very good meetings with our partners, our current partners, and even future potential customers we have met. We see there's a lot of demand. I think that's very good to see regularly, that there is this traction and need in the market for our services. We are making step by step very good progress on the technical side, on the market side. Paris Air Show was very helpful for us. And I think we have a lot of things to do afterwards to catch up with all those people again and make sure we get the traction.